Bleach Rebirth of Souls trailers are coming out every single Monday. And while it is giving us characters that were shown from the original trailer first, and I cannot wait to see what other characters they drop, I do want to kind of do a roster kind of, you know, prediction video before that gets to that closeness of releasing characters and then fit it into the pieces of the puzzle. But I have been a little bit late with these characters, and I'm also, you know, after seeing the Uryu fight again, maybe I'm an Uryu hater, but I just don't find Uryu that fun in any games, to be honest with you. However, I will say that these next three characters, which was Byakuya, Yoruichi, and Chad that we just got yesterday, I wanted to talk to them because I find that this game is getting very, very beautiful, not only with the easily free to play aspect of picking up a character and just shooting the shit, but also there's a lot of tactician going with this, and I wanted to talk and dabble a little bit further and give my thoughts on these characters and my first impressions, and then see how those impressions add up when the game actually comes out. So first and foremost, I want to talk about Byakuya. My first impression on Twitter was we might have our first spam character, and I kind of want to give a little bit of aspect on what I actually mean by that. And also throughout these characters, I want to kind of give my own description of like difficulty level too, because I do feel like that was on the Bleach website too, the game website, that they were going Uryu, Rukia and Ichigo, they were kind of giving a difficulty on how to use them. So I'm going to give my own little difficulty thing. If the website had not already done that already, I didn't really check, but this is my perspective on it. So Byakuya to me is a mid difficulty level. Like, he's easy to pick up, easy to spam, but if you put the time and effort into Byakuya, you can be extremely fucking annoying and extremely toxic to play with. And let me explain why. One, the mechanic to switch in and out of sealed state within Shikai can be a problem if you learn that mechanic well. The character is built to keep a distance from your opponent, which can be in and of itself annoying. Now, I'm not going to say Daedra from the Storm series annoying, where you just keep spamming what those like kunais, but they're not kunais, they're explosives, over and over again, and it can be annoying because you can't really close that gap, or if you could, it was extremely difficult to. I'm not saying Byakuya is anywhere near that level, though the hitbox does look quite bigger than Daedra, to be honest. But I will say that there was this weird, like, you can push it in sealed state. When you choose to go in sealed state, you can push the enemy back, keeping that distance. How many times you can spam that, I don't really know. But there's also seemingly like this vortex thing too, where it brings the character in and it kind of stuns them for a little bit for you to just go in and out in the third. And then of course, with the release of the Bankai, it seems that the more distance you have, or basically it's kind of like a double-edged sword of like, it is meant to keep your opponent at a distance. Like, you stay over there, you don't touch me. The only way you're going to beat Byakuya in that state is if you get close to him, which is canonically true, because the closer you are to Byakuya, he can't use that safe zone that he has. So I love the aspect that the game developers are really thinking really tactical about how these characters are made, what their weaknesses are, what their strengths are, and they're really implementing it into this game. And there's one thing I cannot take away from the developers, is that they are really knowledgeable with the Bleach IP and the story and its characters, and that is making me so much more excited for this game than I anticipatingly thought, if that's a word. But I do think, again, Byakuya is one of those that can be easily spammable if used correctly. I do think many novices will enjoy him, though the weaknesses will be there. But if you are really going to learn the fighting patterns and the combos, and you can switch out a sealed state and unsealed state, you know, within those combos, I think, you know, Byakuya could be a very, very dangerous character to really play with. With that being said though, let's jump on to our next character, which is Yoruichi Shihoin. And let me just say, thank you, Tamsoft. Thank you for uncensoring our Queen Yoruichi. We're finally going to experience the Soul Society arc where her side titty is ass. Ass? Where her side titty is out and the ass is bulging. I love it. I love it. But besides that, she looks amazing. She looks fucking adorable. She looks badass as fuck. And the only note that I rip with Yodowichi is easy. And the reason why I said that is because Yodowichi looks like a very easily pick up and move character. Yodowichi does have some tacticalness with her, whether, you know, you want to lunge him for an attack or you want to lunge him for a counterattack. The ability with Shunko, and it is as I expected with Yodowichi, and I'm interested to see how they're going to do Soifan and how they're going to differentiate Soifan from Yodowichi, and I think that will be a more interesting video to talk about on what they decide to go with that and on their weaknesses and strengths. But I feel like Yodowichi is such a easy character to go, because Yodowichi's whole gimmick, from what I can see, is about speed. And even more speed, meaning that, like, she's so fast that, like, you do after images and you dodge and you can kind of counter so that you as a player can't really hit her. And that's kind of the appeal, is she is a very counter and hit. Or if you're not going to go with the counter and hit, you're going to go with the just keep speed blitzing so they don't move. And I do think Yodowichi is probably going to be one of the easier characters to dabble into, based off my impressions so far. I could be wrong, you know, but that's how I kind of see it. I wonder in this game as well, while watching these videos, I wonder if the health gauges are also going to be different depending on the characters. Are we going to have glass cannons? Are we going to have tanks? What are we going to have? You know, are we going to have the, you know, it's the idea of classes, right? Are we going to have like those healers or DPSs or support characters? What type of characters are we going to have? Are the health bars going to be different? Is the Reishi bars going to be different? You know, X, Y, and Z. Because obviously, you know, Yodowichi is like, for example, like look at Chad, which we'll talk about right now, actually, in fact, like Chad, he's very slow, but he hits hard. Granted, I feel like Chad is going to be a high difficulty character. The reason why I say this is because you are playing a very nerfed game with Chad, but with a high risk, high reward, meaning that Chad is very, very slow. We can see this. He has some moves where it's kind of quick, and obviously he's quick enough where you can actually fight. He's not slow, right? But he's definitely one of those characters where the game emphasizes within the PV that you have to charge attacks, and the more that you charge, the stronger they hit, right? Again, I want to see those damage numbers, right? Are they, is a non-charge versus a charge vastly different in damage? We'll have to find out. But I feel like Chad is built on a last-ditch effort. And what I mean by that, you don't really get to see the benefits of Chad's fighting style until he's awakened, and he awakens both of his arms. Because it even says in the trailer, like, oh, you can now finally fight with both arms now and do more damage. And it's like, well, cool. So does that mean you have to keep getting hit until you get to that awakened state from where you can actually use Chad correctly? Because at the start, it seems like he's nerfed, but then when he's awakened, it seems like he's deadly, right? So it's like, what type of mechanic or game style are you playing with Chad? And do people have the patience to deal with Chad? And I think you have to nerf somebody like Chad for people to play him. Yes, you have to charge attacks, which might be annoying to people, and you're very vulnerable. When you're charging the attacks too, you're very vulnerable. If the damage being done after the charge attacks work in a very good favor towards the person playing Chad, then hey, it might be worth the risk, right? You might be able to take half a health bar in one charge attack. I don't fucking know. But at that point, it would be worth it, right? That's where you have to be tactical with Chad. And that's why I put him on such a high difficulty level, is because if you're going to play him, it seems that you have to play Chad in a very strategic and calculable way. Know your enemy. Know the character. What type of moves do they do? How are you as Chad going to dodge that? So I do think, you know, from me watching Chad, I don't go in with any expectations because Chad's Chad. I don't think he's really ever been really fun in any game. So it was interesting to see how they were going to do Chad. And when I was watching it, I was like, okay, I need to see what type of damage Chad is doing to justify this massive opening of weakness. Yeah, I mean, that's all I can say in regards to that. I'm very excited. We should be seeing like people like Orihime, Renji, and Urahara for the next 3 weeks. And then we're in uncharted territory. But who would you like next out of those? I'm very interested. I think Orihime is going to be next. The reason why I say that is because, again, Orihime is a bit of a healer. So I feel like they want to showcase that type of fighting style next. We have someone like, there's a counter like Yodowichi. We have a long range distance like Byakuya. We have a close range like Chad. And Chad as well, you have to be close range as well. So with people like Uryu, if you're going to fight Uryu or you're going to fight Byakuya, Chad is probably a good matchup, unironically, right? And that's the thing about Chad is, can you get to that close range to begin with? And that's why I'm interested to see how Chad's going to be implemented and how you would play him strategically. And that's what I'm loving about this game is that it's not just a meathead game. There's actually strategy to these characters. And but they're not alienating people to not be strategic as well. And if they want to go in and rush and be a meathead, they have that option. If they don't want to be, they're going to get absolutely diffed by sweats on this game. And that's pretty cool because it makes you want to play and learn the characters more. And I think that has a lot of replayability factor. The only problem for online, because we all know people online are toxic, I think every character is going to be fun playing through the story mode, doing whatever bonus missions they are. I think this is going to be a very fun experience. But I'm waiting for that character that's going to be so fucking toxic online. And so far, to me, I think it's going to be Byakuya. But tell me your guys' thoughts in the comment section down below of what about you think about what my take on these characters are and who you want to see next week. With that being said, tell me in the comment section down below if you also want to see a character select predictions video, and I'll throw that into the mix as well. If those want to know who I'm looking forward to, because Ruruka's not going to be in the game, it's going to be White Ichigo. I love White Ichigo as a character. I love his fighting style. I love that kind of manic, like, fighting style, much like Kid Buu from Dragon Ball, like just insane, unpredictable. So I like White Ichigo a lot, and that's somebody who I'd love to play with. So with that being said, tell me your guys' thoughts in the comment section down below. I'm going to catch you more for today. Hit that like and subscribe, of course, if you haven't already. And as always, people, peace out.